Alright, my friends, back out here at VetteSource today, where we are working on our various fleet of cars here, including our copper metallic that I kind of teased for you guys last week, that we will have more to talk about here later on. Kind of gotten to a basic point on it, but we're just having to work, trying to get some other things out of the irons out of the fire first before I mess with this one too bad. But we'll get to this eventually. We're kind of working on Red Dually over there because it decided to not start the other day. No spark to the engine. We're still going to play around with our Toro here in a little bit. But we're finally making some progress on our 2004 Yukon here. 2500 with the 8.1 engine. Just realized I forgot to unlock it. So what I'm going to do is show you guys where we're at. We got this thing pretty well licked and ready for our new crate marine engine to go in here. So I'll show you what we have accomplished so far. So we got obviously an empty engine bay. And everything actually nicely cleaned up. I came in here and did a lot of hand scrubbing and cleaning just to make sure everything was secure and cleaned up. I just like to have it more clean. This was a clean truck anyway. But took the fuse box out, cleaned it all up, put it back together again. So, you know, other than obviously some grease and grime on the frame rails, we're looking pretty good. So this is ready to go. I did want to go ahead and replace this insulation blanket on the firewall, but unfortunately it is discontinued from GM and I have not been able to find one. Those are not very common. A lot of people forget about them, but with the big block Chevys, you really want to have as much insulation between you and the engine as possible because they do throw off a lot of heat, but I will just have to go with this one for a while. Of course, I'm going to go ahead and change those typical heater hose fittings on GMs that always like to mess up. We're gonna go ahead and change out the power steering lines just because the truck is 20 years old and it needs to be done. Also the oil cooler lines coming from the big block, the 8.1, we're gonna change those. So those are coming in. Knock sensors are coming in for that engine. So we're just about ready to get this thing in here. It's actually, I do like the design of these new engine mounts and these Chevys. GMs, this, especially this GMT 800 series, they make it very easy to get the engines in and out of them. And then of course the way they've got this extra bolt location here on the hood, you don't even have to take the hood off to get the engines in and out. You just put this back, loose, take this out, put the hood back to the second bolt location on the hinge, and it puts the hood straight up and down to what they call the service mode. So you can leave the hood on it without having to take it off and potentially damage it. A couple of interesting things I've noticed here though while we've been working on this truck is that even though this uses, of course, this is a Yukon XL 2500 with the 8.1, it still uses a 480 like the other trucks, the 6.0s, and I think it is just the 6.0s that use that. But the 480 in here has that extra pad on top, and it is particular, and the bolt actually goes through there. It's actually a stud with another bolt because there's a bracket that goes on there, and that actually ties in as a seventh bolt on the back of the engine, which normally you don't see those on the other small block Chevys. So that's an interesting point. Maybe it's to hold the torque of the 8.1. I'm not sure why they did that. And also you'll notice maybe the 6.0s have a 6-bolt torque converter, but I'm not sure. You'll notice this has a 6-bolt converter on it, which is, again, the torque output of that engine is pretty stout. But everything else in here is pretty much generally like the other trucks. Of course, we got your CAN bus wiring system, the PCM here, just like LS engines, the LS style fuse block. There's your throttle control module. So everything here is basically the same that bracket, and of course the power steering assembly is a little bit different. The pump assembly, maybe that's a different pump housing too. I know it's got this crazy extension on it for the 8.1s, and of course the Hydro Boost. I think the Hydro Boost is a little bit different from the 8.1s to the 6.0s. If I remember correctly, they have a different part number. Of course, I'm gonna have to fix that ground strap right there. Those always break. So I need to take care of that one. This one looks pretty good still. Of course, it's an 04 truck, so it's only got the one fuel line, not the return line. And then an interesting thing on this, the PCV valve is built in here. Now, on the marine intake, where this would go in, it does not have, or I'll show you here, the fitting on this. On the marine intake, is actually plugged off. You see it's open on this one. Now, this is the original intake from the motor that blew up, that dropped the rod. So what I'm more than likely going to do is I'm going to go ahead and use this intake rather than try to punch that that plug out of there, out of the marine intake, and then I'll just sell the marine intake, simply because I won't need it for the street application, because it's basically same part number and everything. It's just got the added coating protection on it from the salt water. But all our parts are here contained in the back. Other thing too that is interesting about these trucks that I mentioned one time, and somebody wasn't aware of it, but they argued the point, but this truck does in fact have, there's one fuel tank and there's our other fuel tank right there. Now I think this fuel tank, you see the connection hoses, transfer hoses between the two tanks right there. So I believe that this tank adds an additional 10 gallons maybe. I think part of the problem was they couldn't put the monstrous tank in there because this does not have the body raise like the trucks do, the 2-inch body lift. So this has, I think, a 27 gallon tank there, this one. And I think this one maybe is another 7 to 10 gallon tank. It's actually pretty small. It's not terribly big. It's not very deep right here. So what this one does is gives you a little bit extra range, because an 8.1 is not going to pass up too many gas stations. The other thing too you'll notice here is this does have the 14 bolt corporate rear end underneath it, just not in the dually configuration, more like the single rear wheel like my black truck has that I've worked on here before. And then they moved the evap canister all the way to the back right here, about in between the back bumper and the frame. So that's right there, but everything else is pretty much the same. Of course, springs more heavy duty, but it should look pretty good. It's coming together pretty nicely. It just took me too long to take care of it, but yeah, so the engine is pretty much assembled. We got the new motor mounts on it. We've got I'm waiting on the NOx sensors to come in on Monday. We'll install those, and then we're gonna do is leave the intake manifold off of it. I'm sorry, the exhaust manifold is off of it. The front accessory is off. We're going to drop it in here. Then what I'll do is assemble everything in the truck while it's sitting here. It makes it easier on me, and I don't have to worry about it. So, yeah, pretty much it for now. Just want to let you guys know where we're at with this truck. It's coming along really well. Body work, I'm probably not going to mess with just yet. We'll get to that eventually. But we'll play with that when we have time. Interior wise, I really don't have to do anything to this truck. Probably gonna redo the window tint on this front side. The back ones are good. I need to get another cushion and cover for this. I need to find some floor mats, maybe just some VetteSource I'll put in there. Change a few things. Oh, the one thing that did happen, that typical par for the course, is even though this Freon system is completely still full, the compressor is locked up, so it ain't going anywhere. So we're gonna have to go ahead and do that and put new Freon or new AC compressor and system on it, which we'll take care of. But overall, I'm happy with the way this has come along. Now this one here does not have, it actually is an auto ride, but they replaced the shocks at one point. So, or did they replace them? Yeah, they did. They replaced the shocks, so the connectors are still sitting there. but I'll have to see if I can find the original auto ride shocks for this. I think this was a government spec vehicle at first, or owned by a government entity. If I'm remembering correctly, I have to look at the Carfax again. But it does not have the overhead DVD entertainment system, which at this point it's almost obsolete with the iPad and iPhones and everything else. There's some seats for our Tornado that we found. This one's got the middle row bench seat, so it won't be too bad. There's the rest of our parts waiting to be put in. But overall, we're there. We're almost there, guys. I hope to have this thing fired up within the next 30, 45 days. And of course, I'll let you know as we do the first fire on it to see how it behaves with that marine engine in it. So I want to thank you all for watching with me. Appreciate you stopping by, and I'll check up with you guys next time, okay? Thanks.